The only one who doesn't care about Bossy is her built like a tank daughter, Dai. Remember we saw her babysit Bessie against Bossy's wish before. It probably isn't a good idea standing below a Kwai Muk tree. I think I'll move to those sitting in the sidelines. Like those sitting higher up along the road, these guys are also waiting for their turn too. You can still hear Betsy whining in the background. Life sucks a bit for Betsy with her many domineering aunts, each a mini bossy. More, Gabby is not known to pawn her baby off on a babysitter. Indeed, none of the lowborns do, except Gypsy. Good mothers, most of them are. It takes a good mother to raise a good mother. I think we have pretty much met everyone now, except a few. And so it's time for the lowborns to get their hands on some Kwai Muk. Bossy is still there, but she has had enough. Everyone has a chance, as long as they obey the rules. So Ree has to learn to be a bit less clingy while her mum eats. But she will have plenty of company to take her mind off it. But it looks as though Ree's small whines have worked. so there is a set of rules everyone has to obey. More and more are coming to take what's still left. These are the real lowborns, including Ridgie and her family, who has fallen from grace. But they don't consider it unfair. It's just how their hierarchy works. Thank you. so it's time to go about their monkey business. So is it party time for the babies? And who's the acrobat among them? So Ree wants to say hello to her grandmum. A hilltop nursery. A wrong move, and Trinky will regret. Lastly, we will bump into a few ones we haven't seen in a while too. All will be told in the next episode. Stay tuned, my dear viewers.